right away all the rabbis around the world spoke out against this totally, in each one their style and the most strongest language possible, because it's totally not acceptable. But unfortunately, we say it's the works of Satan, because it doesn't really make sense. Something that should be so clearly unacceptable should be so accepted. We put out a book. There's many books, many of my books. There's many rabbis since Zionism started, which is like 150 years ago, since 130 years ago, whatever. They since that time period when they started, so there's a 130 year record of religious Jewish opposition to Zionism we put out, which is from around the world, from Jerusalem to Europe to Middle Eastern countries, African countries, to West, especially in Europe where Zionism started. We have the leading rabbis around the world stood up and spoke out in opposition to this whole concept before even they created their state. 130 years, because it was 1948 the state was created, but well before, even before, but they decided to make it in Jerusalem, in Palestine, the rabbi said, this concept is blasphemy. This is not what Judaism is. In fact, we're not to make our own nation. It says that Jews are not to make their own concept of a state or a nation, because we're in a decree of exile. There's many that I could mention. Well, of the great rabbis here, let me just... there's some of the great rabbis I wanted to mention, but there was one who was called basically the Chofetz Chaim, they called him, the one who wanted life, though, because he put out a book with that name, and he was Rabbi Kogan, of blessed memory. He was the one of the greatest, except one of the codifiers of Jewish law in the last, of over 100 years ago. And his word is accepted by every single Jew around the world. Anybody who's a religious Jew will say that that he follows the laws, and follows his teaching. As all the others here are from great, here it is, Rabbi Yisroel Meir Kogan, HaKohen. 1839, he was born, so he was before Zionism, to 1933. He passed away before the state was declared. And this is what he wrote in his books, one of his books that we saw. This is like a compilation of quotes, of statements. And he said, "The Zionists are dead limbs of our people, which causes the entire body to riot." That's from Omer Ani Maser Amelech, paragraph 16. I'm just giving an example. And he was a codifier of Jerusalem. Anybody, I can go on and on from all the regions, all the way. There is a rabbinate till today, called Ede Haredes, God-fearing community. There was, when they made the, when the Zionists came, so the chief rabbi at that time was Rabbi Zonenfeld. He was the chief rabbi, this Rabbi Zonenfeld. You can look it up, Rabbi Chaim Zonenfeld. And in 1920, July, I believe, 1920, Rabbi Zonenfeld met with the King Abdullah of Jordan. 1920s, the Zionists were coming up, because they had their meetings in 1890s in Basel, Switzerland. They decided to pick Jerusalem as their center and to come up to Palestine. So they decided to come up there. So this, the Jewish community was over 90% entirely a religious community. Every the Friday afternoon, they would blow a horn, and they would stop work. All the cars would stop going. The Jewish communities, they would knock into stores. The rabbis would go to these stores, make sure that they closed a few hours before Sabbath. The Jewish community was religious, and they were God-fearing, and they were anti-Zionist. They weren't this. Zionists started coming up with their groups, with their settlers, and so on, and they deemed it a threat. So Rabbi Zonenfeld met and put letters in Arab newspapers, and we have a lot of the copies of these, and he put in the Torah opposition, we have some of these documents that they put in letters in the Arab newspapers, and he met with the Arab leaders, with the Arab League, and so forth. In fact, we put out a little pamphlet called the True Religious Jewish Position on Al-Aqsa. In here we have, we're in 19, Rabbi Yosef Chaim Zonenfeld, of blessed memory, he was from 1848, and passed away in 1932. He was the chief rabbi of Palestine, of Jerusalem, called that meant for Palestine. And he wrote, and I'm quoting him, that they put in an Arabic newspaper called El Salam. And he put in, and this is what he wrote, because the Zionists, well, at that time already, were starting, in 1929, were starting to make their groups and starting to agitate. And they started going up and making demonstrations by the Temple Mount. So Rabbi Zonenfeld put in the article in the paper he wrote, and I'm quoting, "The Jews do not in any way want to take that which isn't theirs. And they certainly don't want to contest the rights of other inhabitants to the places held by them, which they regard with honor and consider holy. In particular, there is no foundation to the rumor that the Jews want to acquire the Temple Mount. On the contrary, from the time, because of our sins, we were exiled from our land, our holy temple was destroyed, and we have been lacking the purity required by the Torah. It is forbidden for any Jewish person to set foot upon the grounds of the Temple Mount," which is today, by very stringent, from 2,000 years ago till today, we, the religious community, will not set foot on the Temple Mount before it was off limits or something. Today the Zionists are in control, but even before, I mean, way back when, for all the hundreds and hundreds of years, we wouldn't put foot on there because it's considered, basically it's considered a holy place that you need a certain purification. And it's one is considered one of the worst sins if you do go to that, you step on there, you get cut off from God, we believe. It's like one of the worst things possible. So we don't go there. Sharon wanted to make a statement there for his political reasons, so he went with 1,000 soldiers on the Temple Mount. That started the Intifada, if you remember, and he went there, and he didn't care. In the Torah, it's considered the worst sin possible to go on the Temple Mount, and the Jews held this holy for 2,000 years. He went up there with 1,000 soldiers to make a simple political statement. That's how they totally ignore. So, I mean, you know, here, this is a basic of Judaism. Anything that's holy has nothing to do with Zionism. And we have a rabbinate in Jerusalem, that was Rabbi Zonenfeld. If he passed away, there was Rabbi Dushinsky. Rabbi Dushinsky, after Rabbi Zonenfeld passed away, so Rabbi Dushinsky became the chief rabbi. He was also, he was from Hungary. He was taken because we look for the most, you know, elite, you know, distinguished rabbi to become this distinguished position of chief rabbi of Jerusalem, of Palestine. So his name was Rabbi Yosef Tzvi Dushinsky, of blessed memory. And in 1947, this is before the ratification of the State of Israel, he said he went and went as a delegation to meet with the delegation of the United Nations. That came up to Jerusalem to feel out the issues. Should they ratify? Should they make a Jewish state? Now imagine, he is the leader of the Jewish community that was living there for these hundreds of years. And he stated clearly, and this is in there, this is the United Nations quotes, the United Nations, the picture I believe is also from them. And he said, "We furthermore wish to express our definite opposition to a Jewish state in any part of Palestine." Now he's a religious Jew, a God-fearing Jew. He obviously is not an anti-Semite. He comes along and he says, "We furthermore wish to express our definite opposition to a Jewish state in any part of Palestine." Finished. No, it doesn't matter. It's not interesting if the Arabs will give it to us as a present. We don't want a Jewish state. It's against our religion to have a Jewish state. We're in exile. We don't have this concept of a Jewish state. And of course, the Zionists wanted this Jewish state. They were connected. They were connected with Britain. It was under the British mandate, and they were very well connected. There was somebody called Chaim Weizmann, who became the first president of the Jewish state, and he was a scientist. He was able to help them, I think, make a dynamite or something that they needed by World War One, and they promised him a favor. And he asked that they should help him create the state. So there was the white papers, and then there was Balfour Declaration and all that. So what did the Zionists do? If you're going to have the rabbis say that you're rebels, They did what Reform did. They made a rabbinate. So now, you'll ask anybody, who's the chief rabbi of Palestine, of Jerusalem? Oh, they'll point to the Zionist chief rabbi who traipses around the world, that chief rabbis, and everybody looks at them as the chief rabbi. Their statements are a representation of Judaism, of the Torah. The whole thing's a farce. It's window dressing. We don't recognize their rabbinate. There's a rabbinate that was there from the Rabbi Zonenfeld, from the way before the Zionist state, for the hundreds of years the Jewish communities lived there, a God-fearing community. That didn't stop. We have a rabbinate. We have rabbis, the chief rabbi of Palestine, Rabbi Teitelbaum. He was anointed as chief rabbi of Palestine after Rabbi Dushinsky passed on. It was more. And then he moved to New York, and he urged a lot of his followers to leave, who were all many, many around the world, hundreds of thousands of Jews are followers of this Rabbi Teitelbaum, because he moved from Palestine. He was the chief rabbi of Palestine and recreated a community where you went to Williamsburg. In Williamsburg, that community is almost solid followers of this Rabbi Teitelbaum. If you noticed, there was no Israeli flags. In Williamsburg is the largest concentration of religious Jews, besides maybe from other than Jerusalem or B'nai Brak in Palestine. And there's not one single Israeli flag. Reason being that Judaism is subservient to God. It is not Zionism. On the contrary, the more the religious a Jew, the more we oppose Zionism. There's many schools of Satmar in Palestine, because we have many, many people living in Palestine that are anti-Zionist. As I mentioned, the community was anti-Zionist. Until today, you have many, many Jews, hundreds of thousands of Jews, who are living there, who refuse to accept the occupation. They refuse to serve in the army. We have books and books that we put out of every time we have pictures of Jews being beaten, demonstrations. You have, first of all, a lot of Jews arrested. And first of all, they make the Jews put on army uniform. That's part of the psyche of the Zionists. They put them on green, like army uniforms. I'm going to discuss what this is all about here. What this constantly put out illegally demonstrations. Booklets, because they get calls down. The Zionists come and they calls down any of these. But we put out many times books how Jews are being beaten, arrested, because we constantly demonstrate. Since we never carry guns, the Zionist state is over 70 years now. 71 years, we don't carry guns. You can never hear that we were accused of shooting. We are beaten, we are murdered, our rabbis are assassinated. You can see our demonstrations in Jerusalem, in hundreds of thousands of people demonstrating. I'm trying to get a bigger pictures from you. This is in the city of Jerusalem. This is when they made brought up the new rabbi. This is in 02, the chief rabbi, when they took him up, of the anti-Zionist community. But we have constant demonstrations, tens of thousands of, and they're always being beaten, bloodied, arrested, the Jews when they're demonstrating. Here you can see old men, white beards. You get all these copies I can send you. We can give you high resolution copies of all this. Ongoing, this is here. You can see this is Israeli soldiers, Israeli this. For what? Because we're demonstrating. We never carry guns. They can never accuse us ever that were militant or something. They drive in with horses. They smash their heads. They drive in with cars. People get murdered constantly. This is already for over 70 years. Well over 70 years. The first martyr, famous martyr from us, here you see children, simply because we're standing there demonstrating against the existence of the state. Girls, every child, every boy or girl who turns 17 becomes a criminal because we refuse to serve. It's mandatory military service. We refuse to serve in their armies, the religious. So they get arrested. They put them on these. A few weeks ago now, a girl refused to put on the army, their army guard, which is in the, for the arrestments, have to put on the screen guard. She refused to do that also. So they have demonstrations that but they get arrested, they put on. Here you see she's crying. She's carrying a prayer book, this girl, because she's arrested because she refused to serve in the army. This, you can see, here's a ladies demonstrating. Usually we have pictures of ladies demonstrating. We had Jewish ladies, it's seldom you'll see. They get sprayed with, it's called stink water or something. It's not water. And they're very poor, these communities. Their coals get destroyed. But you can see tens of thousands get beaten, arrested, and murdered. We have pictures of our assassinated rabbis. And a lot of them are followers of the Satmar Rebbe. So we have communities around the world. They are Jews and anti-Zionist, and they bemoan it. Rabbi Teitelbaum used to cry, and he said, how much bloodshed will come from this? He foresaw, even before, because the Zionists thought they'll get a utopia, they'll make a Jewish state. He said, how much bloodshed? Because it says if you rebel against God, you will not be successful. That's what it says in the Torah. The Torah warns us that occupation is a flawed occupation. And spiritually, we're not allowed to have a state, and we believe that one day this state will end. Because in the Torah it says it will not be successful. This stealing the land, creating a Jewish state on both sides. There's the issue, we're not allowed to have a state, even if it would be handed to us, even if it would be bequeathed to us by the Palestinians, say, here, take the land, it's all yours. We would refuse to take it because we're not allowed to have a Jewish state, and we're not allowed to kill or steal. So on both sides of the coin, it's forbidden. No, you know, which way you turn this issue, you're not allowed to have the state. You're not allowed to kill or steal. You're not allowed to have it. Around the world, I'll repeat, around the world, wherever you will go, you can go to here, the United States, largest, the very religious community. You go to Williamsburg, the most largest concentration of religious Jews. Even here in Muncie, which is already more different people are maybe more modern Jews, but mostly it's very religious Jews. Look around. How many Israeli flags you see here? You can find one, two, somewhere you can find, but the whole community is anti-Zionist. You can find the very religious. And you go to London, the very religious community is Stamford Hills. You go to Montreal, you can go to, in the Montreal, the community, you'll see the more the religious the community, the more anti-Zionist they are. Now why? If it's part of our religion, if it's something that we should be yearning for, supporting, like they think like it's the mainstay, and you're considered a traitor if you don't support the Jewish state, how, you know, you're a self-hating Jew. Why? We give our lives for our observance of the Torah. Yeah, we have large families, thank God, an average of 6-7 families. We're not allowed to have family planning. We're supposed to be married by 20, a Jewish child. It's an average of 6-7 children. We have to pay for private schooling because we don't send to public schools because we have Jewish teaching, separate boys and girls. We have our very strict laws of what we teach. That costs fortunes. We have food, kosher food. You can't just buy what's on sale. Clothing. We have to practice Judaism is one that has to give his soul. And at the same time, when it comes to the state of Israel, we oppose it. Now, if it's something that's that's necessary for Judaism, what are we, nuts? How does that work? Obviously, something is wrong here, because the more the religious, the more anti. We stand in opposition. We have stood in opposition. We demonstrate constantly till today. If you will go to our site, NKUSA, and there's also another site called Israel versus Judaism. The facts that we're getting, we took pictures of how they're getting the demonstrations. It's a site that we put that there's constant demonstrations that Jews are being beaten and arrested. We have rabbis that were murdered and so forth. If you go to us at nkusa.org or Israel versus Judaism, and you'll see that hundreds of thousands of the Jews demonstrating constant and awful, and you'll see that this is what Judaism is.